Dear all, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Mu'izz Bukhari recording for the Daily Reminder Network. The greatest of ibadah, or rather the essence of ibadah itself, is something that this nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has been blessed with. And that is dua. Dua, according to the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is ibadah. The individual who does not outstretch his hands and supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our five daily prayers are du'as. The Fatiha that we read in every raka'ah is a du'a to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our lives revolve around various types of adhkar that have been taught to us by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which are all forms of du'a. And our beloved Maker loves to be asked, and he encourages that, as he states in the noble Quran,
وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ
وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. And your Lord, he says, call upon me, I will respond. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Indeed, the ones who scorn my worship shall enter the hellfire, shall enter the fire of Jahannam, humiliated. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. So for this episode and the next one, inshallah wa ta'ala, we will be touching on a few sunan and etiquettes in regard to dua. Number one on the list is that the individual who is making dua, his or her heart must be filled with tawheed, with monotheism. They must ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with deeply grounded conviction, firm faith and belief. Number two on the list is to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he deserves to be praised before supplicating unto him. There is a narration which has been recorded in the book of Imam Tirmidhi rahimahullah. And the narration goes along the lines of these words. Once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was seated and a man comes and prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, forgive me. O Allah, have mercy upon me. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then teaches the man, O worshipper, you have been hasty. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he deserves to be praised. Send blessings and salutations upon me and then call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So first, we should praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he deserves to be praised. And then next in line, this is also derived from the narration that I just mentioned, we must send blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before we begin supplicating unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The final action item for this episode is to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his beautiful and glorious names, as he commands us in the noble Quran.
وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ سَيُجْزَوْنَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
To Allah belongs the most beautiful of names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. Husna is in its superlative form. In other words, the most beautiful of names. The most beautiful of names. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا. Call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Supplicate unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by those beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let us follow these beautiful etiquettes that have been taught to us by the Quran and by our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in regard to supplicating unto our beloved Maker. Please don't forget to share this video around as much as possible to inspire an amazing Sunnah revival. With that, we conclude this episode, and inshallah ta'ala, for the next episode, we will be touching on a few more sunan and etiquettes in regard to dua. Jazakum Allah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.